When I was 17 in Kokomo, Indiana, I harbored wild fantasies of running away to sea. But I went on to college, and my big brother, Alec, dared to live the dream. With his girlfriend, Kate, Alec lived a life rich with romance, danger, and high adventure.
Beautiful day.
What a beautiful girl.
I love you.
I love you.
What a coincidence.
Get over here. This is it or what?
Yes, Alec, this is most definitely it. Alec is a budding screenwriter doing research on his latest script. A tall tale of pirate gold and terror beneath the sea.
Okay, kids, diving time.
That's Max, Kate's father and Alec's best friend. Their quest, true love, lost treasure, and lasting friendship.
Katie, you're gonna love this dive. You're right on the rim of the infamous Nassau Trench.
According to our map, Morgan the pirate sank three of His Majesty's treasure ships, right over there.
Yeah, but now be careful, because at the end of the reef, it drops 6,000 feet straight down.
Right.
Last one to the bottom does dinner.
Take care of my little girl.
Trust me.
Katie, is everything all right?
We found something fabulous. The gold cross.
5th dynasty, Inca carving, 5 masts.
Flawless emeralds.
Oh, it's the cross of the conquistador.
They're worth a fortune. I'm telling you, we're rich, boy. We're going to travel all over the world. We're going to live the dream.
First, we got to get down there and get it. Come on, you can't spend it yet.
I'm right there.
Thank you.
We're gonna live the dream! The dream! The dream!
Danny?
Hurry. Gotta get out of here. There's sharks. There's a whole French dinner down there.
Daddy,
hurry up.
Where's Alan?
Huh?
Where's Alan?
There. It's too late. Here, get him.
Here. What do you mean it's too late?
Here, forget it now.
No.
He's all right.
Yes, Alan!
Hurry up.
Alan! Daddy, go! Stop it!
Firmly believing Alec was dead, Max refused to let Kate risk her life in the shark-infested waters. In desperation, she cut adrift the raft and prayed for a miracle. My brother drifted for days, finally washing ashore at the Twin Canter Condos, Miami Beach.
Shirley, he looks single. No, he's got that married way about him. Just look at him. The pathetic way he begs.
A mist. My Barbara would be perfect.
No, better. My sweet little Rebecca, she could mold him into a real mensch.
Or break his balls trying.
I saw him first.
Celia's dying.
He is not going to die on my Barbara.
Uh huh.
What?
Oh, my goodness. Oh. It's like a soap opera.
Still, it's a camcorder.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my.
Thank God the chicks are saved.
Alex Xavier was part-time lifeguard, full-time med student, Carmen Durango. Slowly and patiently, she nursed him back to health. Believing himself betrayed by both Kate and her father, Alec grew increasingly cynical. When he hit rock bottom, he did the obvious thing. He gave up screenwriting, left for the Big Apple, and slid into the shadowy world of stand-up comedy.
Some of these people that walk around New York, you been over to Times Square yet, Kansas City? These people out there walking around without a brain, out there boxing without opponents, you familiar with these people?
Alec's life became a blur of beautiful one-liners and ugly one-night stands.
What if you went up to him and said, "Ding, Nico, thanks a lot." Holy, man, I was in that round for 5 years.
He grew addicted to dirty jokes, cheap shots, and easy laughs.
Sir, can we see a little bit more of your chest there, you know?
Forsaking everything
and
everyone.
Kansas City, have a good time while you're here. I gotta get
even
going.
Me.
Good night.
His only brother.
Berkman, where are you? Excuse me. I have to sleep.
No, you want to sleep. You have to avoid that truck.
Nice country boy, nice.
I don't like driving in this city.
And yeah, they like you.
Yo, buddy, give me some change.
Hey, working 45th, huh?
Yeah, I got transferred.
You know him?
What? Give him a quarter.
I got a 10. Can you make change?
Change? No problem, buddy. Hey, nice glasses. You want me to clean them for you,
too? No, my glasses are fine.
Hey, let me get you. Hey, thanks a lot. Have a good day.
Hey.
First rule in a big city, bro. No change.
Alec, that cost me $10.
I can't see out of the window. We're gonna die in Times Square.
Here, make a right-hand turn up here. We'll die on the Upper West Side.
But you live in Brooklyn.
I do, but I got a gig later tonight. running the club up there now.
Alec.
Stanley. I'm exhausted. I've been driving.
Hey, it's good to see you, man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Me too.
My last summer before NYU med school, and Alec promised me the time of my life. First stop, New York's hottest after-hours club and casino.
Wait,
are you crazy? You expect me to leave my car here?
Stanley, relax. Hey, hey, hey. Have a party here.
Whoa, whoa.
A new phone?
Seen a car that
big. Looking nice. Whoa, the church meeting's starting over
here. Ah, baby, why don't you be away, no drain, old lady?
Frankly, I'm looking for something a little higher up in the food chain.
Oh, hey, baby, come on, darling. Come on, sweetheart, I love you. Oh, you're giving me a complex puzzle, retort. Come on, darling, come on. Hello, Pongo. I'm just here to do a little dancing.
What is going on here?
I guess I got one fun.
Oh, he broke my leg. Oh.
Bueno, Drano. How are you gonna be dancing with a broken leg?
Let's get out of here.
And now, folks, for the first time in the big time, let's have a nice, warm, kamikaze club welcome for the talented Alec Berkman. Hey!
Hey, sorry I'm late, actually. Just totally embarrassed myself out in the street. I have that on the same pair of pants I had on last night. I don't know if you ever do this, but on the same pair of pants in the morning that you had on the night before, halfway on your way to work, you see that large bulge growing on the back of your thigh? Same pair of underwear you left in your pants from the night before? Probably get rid of it just like I do. Well, let's see. Nobody around here. I'll drop it right there. I'm out of here. Are we partying? Are we drinking down some beers here? I see you guys, yeah? No more for me. And I used to drink a lot. I really did. But I had that cutoff point in my life. I don't know, you know? You ever get so wasted, you go to play a jukebox, pack of Marlboro comes out? That's time to reevaluate.
You don't want to start, you don't want to take, you don't want me. I'm like, Dad, whoa, whoa, whoa. What the hell did you just say? What do you want, a beer? What's going on?
That's it for me. Thanks a lot.
Alec, that was good. I mean, great, really great.
Thanks, man. I thought you liked it.
Yeah, so we go home now?
Go home? Hey, first we unwind a little bit, all right? Unwind, really then whoa! Then maybe we have another lick or two over here, thanks, and then we'll go home, all right?
18 black.
Oh. Give me your wallet.
Why?
Hey, lesson number two in the big city, all right? There are pickpockets everywhere. Come on, trust me, I'm your brother. Come on.
That's everything I got. All my money for the summer and med school.
Okay, now lesson number three. Don't trust anybody, not even your big brother. Seven chips for this.
Alec!
Come on, these are invaluable lessons. Easily worth a loan of a couple of dollars. Come on, hey. I understand these games, all right? They're not just luck.
Roulette is scientific?
Of course it's scientific. What day of the month is it?
First.
That's red. One red. Let's go with it.
No. You know, let's not go with it.
No more bets.
That's all winter at the 7-Eleven. That's got to last me.
One red.
Whoa.
One red.
What? What? We won? What did we win?
What did we win? A lot. We won a lot, okay?
Place your bets.
You want to rub me for luck?
Alec doesn't need luck. He's smart. He created this place. He runs it.
Place your bets.
You want to ride on the red?
That's my favorite way to fly.
Alec, no, please. Alec, you're crazy. The odds are impossible.
Nothing worthwhile is impossible.
Let's go for it.
See my whole life spinning before me.
No more bets. One red.
Oh my God! Oh my God! Oh! My feet are gone! My We won! Look at all my money!
Girls, this one's for you. Get some more outfits, a little less clothing. Honey would be nice.
All right, here you go. You just won this.
No, nice!
Oh, jeez. Don't tell Mom.
Okay.
Alec. Johnny!
Alec, what are you doing to me, Alec? You got a lot of my cash there, and that does not make me happy.
This is Johnny Zero, kind of owns, runs things around here.
You told me you ran the place.
Him? This is my club, Ground Zero. The only thing I'd let him run is my dishwasher. Now, look, before you get your butt backstage and get ready for the next set, I want you should slime over to my office and very privately apologize and give you back what's mine.
Whoa, Johnny, I just won that money.
To help don't win nothing.
Johnny, look, I just won...
Nothing. Unless you might discuss this with Bongo in the alley. I'm sure he'd like to slip on his hobnail sneakers and do a little Jose Greco on your cabizo, amigo.
Sir, we won this money legitimate.
You don't know what the similarity is between Bongo and a one-inch dick?
No!
But you just can't fuck with either of them.
Oh, thanks.
Johnny, look, let's just go back to your office. We'll talk about this, all right?
Now, you're making me happy. I got some employee relations problems. Just take a minute to fix. You just wait in my office like a nice little funny boy.
You got my Louisville slugger?
So, this is all yours, huh? A first-class upscale comedy club with music, bar, dancing, and gambling.
Well, you know, sex, booze, money, and laughter. That's an idea whose time has come.
I'm Vera Von Rouge. And these are my friends. This is Cinnamon. Spice.
Well, hello.
And Paprika.
Ooh, what, oregano couldn't make it?
She didn't have time.
Well, not only very pretty, but very funny.
Hi. I'm
this is my baby brother.
Younger brother, Stanley.
I was hoping we could convince you to come with us, huh? To the islands.
Long Island? Staten Island?
The Bahamas. I want you to recreate all this, manage and design a very first-class upscale comedy club.
Wow.
Alec, let's go.
Do you think we could have some privacy, perhaps, in your...
Actually, Alec doesn't have an office.
Awful lot of time. So let's get going to the office and let's talk about this.
Girls, take care of Stanley.
Stanley, keep a lookout.
Here's Stanley.
Oh, look how cute.
Champagne?
Of course.
Yes. Oh, my girl.
Let's get down to business, shall we?
What exactly did you have in mind?
Well, I happen to run the largest luxury hotel in the islands.
All right, funny man. Whoa.
Sorry, I got distracted.
Hey, Berkman.
Hey, come on. Later, dude, all right? You seem a little jammed up here right now. You know, what with Groundhog Day just a month away. And hey, I did promise a friend of mine I'd teach him how to tie his shoes, so...
The hell are you talking about?
Who the hell let this bozo in here anyway? Look, hombre, this is not the kitchen, okay? This is my office. All right, can you open the door to the kitchen, please?
Hey, wait up.
Kitchen? Right, he's got to get back to work in the kitchen. He's afraid of the dishwasher. He thinks it's possessed.
What the hell is going on?
What a confused amigo. Back to work, my friend. Back to work. The king. I need key. In the kitchen. It won't hurt you.
Get back. Want my money now.
No. See, technically, it's ours.
Alec, what is this lunatic babbling about?
My money.
Your money.
My money.
The money I owe you.
My money.
Here's the $20. Great job on the urinals, all right? I'll see you Thursday. We'll do tacos.
Bongo! Let me out of here!
Bongo! It's the Texan cry of happiness. Bongo!
Send you my car.
318 Atlantic Avenue, the penthouse.
Oh, Atlantic Avenue, Mr.
Maslund. Oh, gentrification's on the way. I just bought the whole block.
Yay!
Hey, what do you say we give you a call?
Oh, please do, and we'll put the deal.
Stupid.
Oh, call soon. I'll leave exactly at 1.
Whoa! 1's my lucky number.
Bongo!
Alex, you're gonna have to excuse me.
Sorry.
My car! All my stuff!
I had a good life, sir.
I don't know why you parked here anyway. All my stuff is in that car. My books from med school, my whole life was in that car.
Well, we'll buy you a new life. We'll go to the life store and get you a new life.
Oh, help! Help!
Help me! Could you help me?
Yeah, please? Yeah, what do you need? Around the neighborhood.
Oh, pacemaker's gone. Please give it back to the house. It's just over this way.
Which way?
It's over this way. Oh, please help me. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. You're going to get off the ends of my back. Listen, child. It was so kind of you. Could you now push me into this dark, dangerous alley over here?
No, you don't want to go down there. You don't know what's down there.
It's true, son, but it's the only home I have.
No, I can't push you down there.
Push me!
Okay. All right, do you live down here? Yeah, a little frightening.
How about laying some bread on a deserving old lady?
You're hungry, are you?
Don't be ridiculous, son. I mean cash. Presume a buck's the long
money, lead. Money, she has no money. You need some money, is that it?
Of course I need money. Son, I have nothing to call my own. Nothing left. Except in this old wheelchair and this. Fully functional family heirloom.
Alec!
Move, leave or leave! Now, bring on the bucks, boys!
All right. You gotta be in a desperate situation to pull a gun on us like that.
Son, do you know what a steel jacketed 44 Magnum can do to you? Slams into your face the size of a diamond and roars out the back of your skull like a friggin' flying saucer.
All right, what do you want?
All of it. Your cash, your credit card, your cash. Come on. Pull it out. Give me the money.
All right.
Give me the money.
All right.
Come on. Give it to me.
Here it is.
Come on. Cough it up. Take off. One more. Come on, buddy. Now give me that pants. Come on.
Pants.
What are you whispering?
I was just telling my brother how much you reminded me of my mother from Indiana. Kokomo.
Well, that's amazing because you look just like my son, my little boy.
Mom, just put down the gun, okay?
Oh, I had such high hopes. He's out there, somewhere, under a pale light, doing stand-up, shelling out, the deranged dirtbag, the slime-snipping snug, and the testy little mutant sleazoid bastard!
Okay, here they are.
Here are the pants. Here are the
pants?
Get those pants off. Don't waste time with those zippers. Just pull them right down.
Pants are coming off.
Here they come. Look at my pants.
Bitchin' shorts, dude.
Those are my shorts. You gave them to me for my birthday last year.
Oh, no, sucker.
Sure, Alec, anything you say. Yeah, right around the corner. 3 hours later, we crossed the Brooklyn Bridge, just a block away from Alec's fabulous penthouse.
Okay, lesson number 4, life in the big city. I got your basic K-Sergeant Medico lock with a double-action titanium cylinder. This baby, she's secure.
Just like you described it.
Alec, is that you?
Hey, you're in town one day already hitting on my girl? Carmen, what happened here?
What do you think happened? You got ripped off again. They took everything, your money, your furniture, your stereo, everything but your stupid yo-yo.
There is a God.
Hi, I'm Alec's brother, Stanley.
Hello, Stanley. I'm Carmen Durango. I'm very pleased to meet you, and I'm leaving your brother.
Well, leaving? But you're leaving all of this? What are you, brain dead woman? Look what I've made for you here. All this is yours when I die.
Alec.
Yeah?
I'm crazy about you. Mm-hmm. I'm leaving you for Wally Ringlethorpe.
Wally Ringlethorpe? You're leaving me for that second-hand anchovy salesman from Teaneck? Why?
Alec! We had an important date last night.
What? Right. Oh, geez, it's our anniversary. Oh, your birthday?
Bingo!
I couldn't say that first.
I get here, no Alec, and the place had been ripped off. I was here alone. I could have been raped by some drug-crazed, oversexed, creepazoid, lunatic psycho!
Hey, don't blame me because the guy left early.
Oh, see? You're never serious. You're never committed to anything but your practical jokes and chasing women.
Hey, come on. I'm fun. I am fun.
You're fun, but you're an adolescent. Totally independent.
Me?
You're just a big baby.
Well, that's what the women love about me. Because I'm so dependent. I'm nothing without them. I mean, come on, you can mold me into anything you want.
What I want is a man, not Play-Doh.
Hey, look, if you have no confidence in me, just come out and say so.
I have no confidence in you! Stanley, look at your brother! He's a loser!
Right. I admit it's not a pretty picture, okay? But look, I am trying.
No. Your history and I'm out of here! Wally's got a week off and I really need a vacation out of New York. So, Alec, I am going to go with him. And you can just play with your yo-yo.
Let me tell you something. This place used to be beautiful before they took everything.
And everything but the kitchen sink.
Right. Sink. The one absolute safe place in New York. Check it out. $50.
How about we call Vera?
Right. You know, I have made her suffer long enough. Dial tone.
Unpaid phone bill. Oh. Credit card, March of Dimes, sweepstakes. Oh, letter from Mom. Eviction notice.
Letter from Mom?
Alec, Vera leaves in less than 10 minutes.
10 minutes. Pay phone on the corner. Come on, let's go.
You got a pair of pants?
Pants, right, hamper.
before she leaves without us.
Stanley, relax, okay? I got this. Excuse me, you're gonna be on this phone for long. You're gonna be on the phone.
Till I'm finished.
Okay, sounds like a good time.
Goodbye, Ma. Goodbye, Ma.
Give me a quarter.
Quarter?
Yes, a quarter.
I don't have a quarter, Alec.
Give me a quarter.
If I had a quarter, I wouldn't have paid $10 to have my car window soaked. Correction. My broken down, broken into, whipped and stripped, totally devastated, currently abandoned car window soaked. Nice. Yes.
Now, where's that phone number? And where? Oh, my wallet, the old lady. Oh.
That's it. I just want to die right here, right now. What else could go wrong?
Johnny Zero.
Right, I forgot about you.
No,
Johnny,
he's
Zero.
Behind you. Johnny Zero.
I don't bite. Yet. Alec, I'm on my way to the ship, and I just had to have your answer. Are we going to the Bahamas?
The Bahamas.
Oh, I can't go. No way I can go. Oh, I'm right in the middle of a really big real estate deal, and there's no way.
I would be very grateful if you would consider this.
I can't budge on this one. It's not that I don't want to go, but I just shelled
Alec,
out a great deal
about?
Of money for some condos.
If you were to say yes right now, I'm prepared to offer you, say, $10,000.
A piece.
A piece.
Yes.
Just say yes.
Yes! Yes!
Yes.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Yes!
Yes!
The Bahamas!
Here on board. We have shuffleboards, sliding, skating, sauna, skeet shooting, water polo, chess, checkers, dining, dancing, and gambling. Just about anything. We just don't happen to have a game that involves the actual killing or mutilation of a living human being.
You have a hard hitting and hurting a lot.
You are perhaps into pain.
Oh, check it out. The playground's open.
Get your Alec glove.
Alec!
Alec!
Johnny! Hey!
Surprise.
Johnny, how are you, man?
Good.
Right. Hey, you look good. You
yeah,
look good.
Well.
What are you on vacation, Johnny?
On a cruise.
Nice. Catching up on some reading, too, right?
Yeah, you know, all work and no play. Ooh, I'm reading a book right now. Gray's Anatomy.
Yeah. Gray's Anatomy.
Oh, right.
Whoa! Sir, wait!
Exactly 206 bones.
206, eh, Johnny?
Human body. That's
I didn't know that.
206. And what I'm thinking is, if Bonga here were to break the bone in the tip of your little finger, you'd have 205 left. And if you were to break another one, you'd have 204. Another one, 203, 202, 201. Take a long time to break all the bones in your body.
All right, Johnny, Johnny. What do you want me to do?
I want you to suffer.
A lot.
Excuse me, pal. My friends and I would like to get by. Not now, all right, Vera?
Hey, if you can guess my weight, I'll give you a special treat.
Not now, all right, Vera?
Come on.
Not now, Vera.
Oh, come on, guess.
All right, 500 pounds.
Close enough.
Look, Vera, it's not that I don't find you incredibly appealing, okay? Mm-hmm. But I'm being chased by a couple of homicidal killers that want to blow me away, all right?
Danger is so sexy. Oh!
Well, maybe I'll be safe here.
Oh, feeling safe always gets me aroused.
You might have followed me.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Well, maybe they didn't.
Oh, uncertainty is the ultimate aphrodisiac! Have 48 more hours of soaking sex together.
Whoa, ho, ho, ho. Hey, let's slow down a little bit, all right?
Mm-mm.
Anyway, we got the whole summer.
Mm. Well, maybe you do, but I'm getting married on Monday.
Getting married on Monday, that's funny.
A girl can't sow wild oats forever. I gotta think commitment.
You're getting married on Monday.
Mm-hmm. We only have 48 more hours. And then I have to say goodbye to...
You're getting married on Monday!
If you're up before me, just give me a poke.
Right. And what am I supposed to do if those killers come in here?
Oh, just blow their freaking
off. Oh, okay, Vera. All righty. Time to come back to planet Earth, all right? Put the toys away. Go to Betty Bye.
Okie dokie.
Who's that?
Who's that? Hey, how do you like that? Who's that? No respect even on the high seas.
Who's
hey,
there? Who is it? Who are you?
My name is Lieutenant Columbo. I'm looking for my wife.
Look, I got a gun. I'm going to use it.
Well, you can put that gun away, Pilgrim. Yeah. Oh, nice. Kevin, Alec.
Johnny.
This got to cost a lot of money. A lot of my money. But like I always say, what's money? As long as you got your health. Nothing more important than that. Keeping your health.
Johnny, I don't have the money. Johnny, I don't have the money, all right? One comic to another, I don't have it. When I left the club, I got robbed by an old lady in a wheelchair. Johnny, and when I got home, my apartment was robbed.
Hey, it could happen to anybody. So you took your spare pocket change and took a first-class cab into the Bahamas. Isn't that so, you scum-sucking, mung-covered maggot? You pay or die.
I don't have
long to live. Say, arrivederci to your coglionis.
Take it easy. Let me introduce myself. Elliot Peterson, Chief of Police, huh? Let's go.
What did you use on the door?
I had a key. I was invited.
Yes.
Okie dokie. Who's here?
Miss Van Rouge.
Why, Elliot. How nice to see you.
I'm so very sorry to disturb you, but this gentleman claims that he was an invited guest in your room.
Oh, well, he's a very handsome young man, but I'd say that was wishful thinking on his part.
Vera!
You were alone.
I certainly went to sleep that way.
That's a lie!
I sleep very soundly.
I see.
Oh, and I awoke to these strange holes on my pillow.
They look like bullet holes.
They look like big bullet holes.
They are bullet holes. Look, this is ridiculous. There is a dead body right over here. There isn't a dead body here.
Do you want to press charges, ma'am?
No. Alec is my guest and a headliner at the club here. If he felt a sudden urge to break into my room in the middle of the night and shoot large caliber bullets into my pillows, showering my body with feathers while I sleep, dreaming of my impending marriage to my dear Maxie, the sweetest man on earth, then I'm sure he has a very good reason. Didn't you, Alec?
I can't stand this anymore. Where are my pants? I left them right there.
Oh, Alec.
He stole them. Just like the old lady in the wheelchair with the Magnum, he stole it. I hate this.
Old lady in a wheelchair with a Magnum. Son, do you do drugs?
Stand up. I do stand up.
They got a cure for drugs.
Oh, it's okay, Elliot. You'll be all right in my care.
Well, I'll be leaving now. Just buzz cabin 12 if you should have any more trouble.
Thank you, Elliot.
Good night, Miss Van Rouge.
Good night. I thought he'd never leave.
Vera, what is this all about and why did you lie?
Oh, Alec, my husband-to-be owns the ship. Hell, he owns the whole line. Did you really want me to tell his good friend and best man, who also happens to be the chief of police in Nassau, that 2 days before the wedding, I was in bed with a second-rate comic.
Second-rate?
Oh, relax. You men have such fragile egos. Oh, I'm sorry to let you down, Alec. Let me get you back up. How does that feel?
How does that feel? Like a James Bond martini. Shaken, but not stirred.
The next day, Vera's little fun ship pulled into port. A long, long way from Kokomo.
They're moving their feet, they're shaking their hip, they move their body line. They're moving and grooving, shaking and whining, shake their body in time. I say, they're moving their feet, they're shaking their hip, they move their body line. They're moving and grooving, shaking and whining, move their body in time. Hey!
Alec and I took the opportunity to enjoy the island's more simple outdoor pleasure. While high above, our favorite femme fatale gave vent to her animal instincts.
So long, I thought I might have forgotten how.
Oh, it's like riding a bicycle. You never forget how. Meow, meow, meow.
Right, it is like riding a bicycle. It's like riding a stingray with a banana seat, like the blue one I had when I was growing up. It was chrome. I polished it so good. I put these little things in the handlebar and the bicycle really fast. You were like, vroom.
Shut up and pedal faster. My one and only, I love you. I've got to see you.
It's too dangerous, darling. Do as I told you. Proceed with the plan.
Okie dokie.
To my new wife.
L'chaim. What's the matter?
I'm beginning to not feel so good.
You need some more wine. Nighty night, my little rattlesnake. Something I did? Is it my outfit?
You're not gonna shoot your new husband.
Oh, my husband? No, I thought you were an intruder.
Is this some kind of a joke?
I am learning stand-up. Hey, here's where I knock him dead. I just want you to know I wouldn't be doing this if you weren't worth millions. That's a good boy. I poisoned you and I shot you. Now I want you to be a good husband.
and die.
What is your problem? I plotted and I planned this for 3 months. Now, if you love me, I want you to do the decent thing and die! 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 All right, already. Oh, you're really starting to piss me off. Get a life, will ya? A guy like you, I could throw for free! I'm getting too old for this.
Very resourceful guy. Or should I say, your future husband is going to be a very resourceful guy.
After the wedding, you kill your new husband. I plant the appropriate evidence on the fall guys. I love it.
Oh, and I love you. Oh! Oh, you really are a magic man. God, just the thought of all that violence gets me so
aroused.
Really? So am I. Stanley? Alec?
Hi, Vera.
Hi, Vera.
Hi. I'd like you to meet my friend here, Speed.
Speed. Hi, Speed. Now, is that your name or your drug of choice?
It's very clever, but I'm not on drugs. I'm a master magician performing here at the club.
You know, we had a magician come through Kokomo once. Remember him, Stanley?
Yeah.
Yeah, he did a couple of card tricks.
He sawed a lady in half?
Right, he sawed her right in half.
They were impressed.
Oh, yeah. Burned him as a witch.
You're such a card. Alec, I was wondering if you could do me a great personal favor.
Sure.
Drive out to the airport and pick up my future stepdaughter. I think you'll like her.
Vera, I don't even know what she looks like.
She looks like just your type. You bring me flowers. I'll plant the seeds. Dancing for hours. Just you and me. When the rain comes through the darkness. Sweet and tender love is everlasting. And I promise.
Came here for the first time.
And I kissed you for the first time.
Is that you?
Hey! Well, maybe this will jump. Lost and found, just you turn around. And I'm waiting.
Now you have really fine piano playing. Always gets me so
aroused.
It's him. He's early. Boomer, my little Wiener Schnitzel, you're early.
Yes, but am I, darling?
Every thought of you drives me insane. I want you now, my darling, to ravish your magnificent...
Come over here, my little boomerang.
Whoa.
To the bedroom. By our films, Catholic high school girls in trouble.
Even hotter, my love. It sizzles. I took it myself on the balcony outside of Bump's bedroom.
The balcony outside of Bump's bedroom?
That's less than an hour ago.
So does this mean you don't want me anymore? My little poo-poo platter.
On the contrary, I hate myself. I lust for you more than ever. You are something very unique, and I shall dwell in the house of love forever.
Oh, dim sum.
And then some.
Honey, I'm home.
It's my fiance.
Are you alone, my little petunia blossom?
Sorta. Fix yourself a drink, honey lamb.
All right, my dear. Sweetness, how selfish of me. Let me make a drink for the both of us.
Now, you agree to dump Bump and marry me after we murder Max, so I will blow him away and blame you and Bump.
Here I come, sweetheart.
Refuse me. And at the bachelor party, I will show the incriminating tape and speed you and Bump to the slammer.
Here I come, little shuckums.
Just a minute, precious face. Okay, it's death to the Max.
I'm coming, my dear. I'm so sorry. Forgive me. I wouldn't have barged in if I had known you had company.
Oh, there's nothing. Vera and I were just going over the final plans for the party. Vera, would you pick the pink or purple plates for the pirate party?
I would pick the pink plates for the pirate party. Now, why don't you run along before Maxie gets some crazy ideas about finding you and me in bed together near naked in the middle of the afternoon?
Oh, no, no, no. Me suspect my soon-to-be wife to be having a sordid affair with my longtime business associate and closest and dearest friend. That's a joke.
I may use it. I'm doing stand-up now.
Very funny. Speaking about comedic performances, you outdid yourself on this tape, Vera. It's very funny. I may show it at the bachelor party tonight.
You have your own stand-up act? Vera, I'm so proud.
So, what about old Maxie?
He sold the cross, got rich.
Sold the cross and got rich. Your father and I have a long-standing agreement. Anything we find together at sea, we share it.
Alec, I'm sure of him. Once he knows you're alive, you'll share in it. Half the money is yours.
No thanks. I'd rather be poor and alive.
Alec, Are you absolutely sure of what happened in those final seconds?
Yes, I'm absolutely sure.
Are you really? Max was sure you were dead, so maybe you were both wrong.
Well, I don't know what to think, okay? I just don't know.
It was just an awful mistake. And tomorrow he's about to make another. He's getting married.
Max is getting married. You're serious?
Yeah. Wedding is a joke. This vampire Vera is after Dad's money.
What? Vera? Vera von Rouge?
Yeah, you know her?
Yeah, I know her. And you're right. She is after his money. Our money.
You trust nothing else. Trust this.
Paprika. Have you gotten close to Stanley yet?
Very close. It's crazy about me.
Well, keep it that way. I want to know everything about him and his ridiculous brother.
You got it.
Ta.
While Paprika was keeping very close tabs on me, voracious Vera contemplated her impending fortune to the soulful sounds of Max's snoring. Meanwhile, her playmates Speed the Prestidigitator and Boomer the Sleazoid had infiltrated her precious little spice rack.
Cinnamon, of all the tricks I do, the very best ones, I do with you.
Speed, this is a dangerous game.
Oh, my goodness. You know, Spice, I want you to appear on the front cover of my annual Torts Illustrated lawsuit issue.
Oh, we'll have Max's money, and I'll be a star.
Yes.
How much longer do I have to wait?
Look, it's simple. Once she's wed, she gets the bread. I louse her spouse. Max gets the axe. With the groom in the tomb, Bongo smothers the Berkman brothers.
Could you explain that again?
I really don't think so.
A petite problem. Boomer.
Boomer?
The fried wonton videotaped our little tryst this afternoon. And if I don't agree to marry him after we do in Max, he's gonna show the tape at the bachelor party tonight.
When will you kill him?
I will start tonight. I'm sure that bitch Vera has betrayed me to Speed Bump.
Don't worry. I have a little novelty item. He is going to love.
They all fought over Max's money like ants on a melting Hershey bar. All except Brother Alec, who still had serious doubts about Max.
See you. Oh, sweetheart, I'm so glad you decided to come.
Kate, my child.
Oh, my God. Alec.
No, not your God, Max. It's your good old friend, Alec Sharkbait Berkman.
Alec, how did you...
A little yellow raft. Smile from Lady Luck.
Hello, Alec.
Oh, you know each other?
Vera? Max, your bride has been very, very, very kind to me.
Can I pick him or can I pick him?
You sure can't pick him, all right, Max. You sure can't pick him. You know, Vera signed me on to work here at the comedy club. Isn't that a laugh?
Listen, there's gonna be millions of laughs. It's gonna be just like we planned. I'm telling you, kid, half of everything I've got is yours. You're gonna be rich, kid. We're gonna be rich. We're gonna live the dream. We gotta celebrate.
Here we are.
Tonight is my bachelor party. Now we toast to Vera, the virgin bride.
To Vera, the virgin bride.
I'm so glad I waited.
night at the bachelor party, Alec and Max called a truce long enough to indulge in an age-old ritual of male bonding, and promptly got totally wasted.
Yeah, it's in the past, it's over.
Meanwhile, back at the hotel, Speed Bump was working his old black magic on Cinnamon.
Oh, I have a present for you.
Oh, you do?
Made it myself.
Oh, you did? Speed, you shouldn't have. Naughty boy. You sure this isn't for you?
I want you to replace the dancer at the bachelor party tonight. And you must wear that bra.
So unhook me.
Not yet. Turn around. Boomer and only Boomer gets to unhook the bra.
I thought you hate that dork.
More than you know. Turn around. Unhooking the snap breaks an electric circuit, causing two transistorized miniaturized pistols, cleverly concealed in the nipples, to fire.
Come on, Max. You're the most vital man I know. Come on. But sometimes a woman clouds our judgment. All right?
Poor drunken Alec just couldn't stop himself from telling Max what a schemer Vera was.
You're talking about Vera. You're talking about my wife.
I'm talking about your life, Max. She does not love you. My God, Max, she has slept with everybody on his boat.
Hey, hey, are you saying that Vera would? Now listen, you lying little jealous bastard. It's a pity that I didn't.
It's a what?
You heard
a
me.
A pity, Max? A pity what? That those sharks didn't finish me off like you planned, Max?
Like I planned? You ungrateful son of a bitch!
Max, come on. This funk is not worth it. Come on, Patty. Hey, it's your party. Hey, come on, everybody. Music! Dance! Come on, party! Women!
Try some of my home cooking.
Hey there. Shake it, honey. Whoa.
Little girls are made of sugar, made of everything that's nice. But if you're getting tired of eating candy, here's your chance to try some spice. Mama raised me like a lady. She taught me what was wrong from right. Now I go out in silk and satin.
Jail, buddy man. Consider yourself lucky, eh?
Excuse me. Chief Peterson. Miss Van Nuja sent me.
Vera sent Cinnamon with the bail money.
And wishes to bail him out.
After all, Alec can't be in jail while he's being framed for Max's murder. Even Peterson wouldn't buy that.
Trust me, my little baboon. It will work.
Trust you? A woman who plans to murder her husband during the actual wedding ceremony that she marries him. Of course I trust you. I'm just worried that you'll be the prime suspect.
Oh, it's so deliciously outrageous, no one will believe it. I read his will. On the day after her 21st birthday, Kate inherits all his money. He's gonna retire and spend all his time with me.
The will of some people.
And I get to fulfill his little boy fantasies, which are all nautical, not sexual. Max plans to sail around the world on a permanent honeymoon. Speed, I get seasick in the hot tub. And on that puny sailboat, there isn't any room service.
You know what they say. Where there's a will, there's a way, even when there's a will in the way.
Okay.
When does she become 21?
In 3 days. So we gotta get our buns in motion.
Vera and Speed plot Max's murder.
In fact.
And so, a small but strange wedding party gathers. Vera's crack about Max's nautical fantasies seems to be all too true.
Oh, this doesn't happen every weekend.
Oh my God, look! It's his air valve, it's his air valve! This is no accident.
What do you mean no accident?
Look at his valve!
As expected, Lieutenant Peterson moved swiftly and rounded up the usual suspect.
All right. Come here. Now let's take it from the top. What were your hands doing in those valves, huh?
Elliot, let me have them for a few minutes.
What?
Please, just for 2 minutes. Please, as a favor, come on.
Max wasn't so sure of Alex's guilt.
You watch him?
Yes, sir.
L'chaim!
Meanwhile, Vera and Speed, undaunted by their underwater fiasco, took great pleasure hammering out ever more devious ways to do in Max.
You know, I don't know what happened, actually, when I was down there.
Back at police headquarters, Alec and Max began to face their doubts about each other and seemed to salvage their lost friendship.
I do know that it's starting to eat me away, and I just have to find some way to resolve it.
Well, the first thing we're gonna do is get you the hell out of here. Elliot! I'm not pressing charges. I'm betting on Alec.
So, Alec was set free to help the newlyweds celebrate.
This is the
line.
Thanks, Mike.
As for me, I kept a sharp eye on Vera's vixens.
I could never do that.
Oh, yes, you
could. I'm afraid of heights. Hey, looks like fun, though.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he's going high. Look at that.
Wow.
Save Max. I forgot I couldn't swim and promptly sank right to the bottom of the pool. You've really got to love these fancy resorts. Always a pretty lifeguard handy to save your drowning butt. In this case, mine.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Stanley?
Carmen?
Here.
I came down with Alec. Hey, Alec! Kate, over here!
Well, I see your brother still has an eye for beauty.
That's Kate.
About Kate. He never got her out of his system. Not even when he was with me.
Well, it was a real weird coincidence.
Yeah, but don't worry about it. It's okay. I mean, it's nothing new. Maybe down deep, that's why I left it.
Hey, what happened to your anchovy salesman from Tina?
Him? He had no sense of humor. I sent him home.
You know, everyone says I've got a fantastic sense of humor. That night, we all had something to cheer about. Max had cheated death, Alec was out of the slammer, and I had found my dream girl.
Thank you, thank you.
And now, my most dangerous illusion of all, the cage of death. I'll need a volunteer from the audience. How about you, sir? The gentleman in the corner drinking a beer? Make your friends proud. I assure you, sir, you have nothing to fear. Give him a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Sir, I want you to examine this cage very closely. Make sure there are no hidden compartments, no trap doors. Nothing up my sleeves, nothing up here, nothing up here. Nothing up here. And now I'll need a second volunteer. A brave man, brave enough to share in the most dangerous game of all, a game of life and death.
Ooh, and you're the bravest man I know. Oh, come on. Please.
Oh, hell, why not?
You'll see. What's going on here?
Got bumped, and Vera, the former widow-in-waiting, now stoically faces her fate. A life sentence at sea with Max.
There we were, 40 days and 40 nights at sea we were. Shipwrecked 3 leagues off Point Blanc, off the island of Arugula.
Max celebrated Kate's birthday with a little pirate party. It was Vera's last chance.
Oh, Katie, darling. Here you are, my little baby.
As Max was forking over his fortune to daughter Kate, Vera contemplated a nautical nightmare in waiting.
And tomorrow we'll go to the lawyers, and then the palace will be yours. And then your stepmother and I are off to the open sea. Oh, Vera. Isn't it exciting just thinking of the two of us alone out there? For months and months on end. Eating what we catch, living off the bounty of the sea. Oh, I'll spear all those squid and shark and barracuda and Portuguese man of war and all those other huge and dangerous fish. And then they'll thrash upon the deck and you will come out and you'll pull the hooks out of their bloody mouths and you'll gut them and you'll scale them and you'll cook them and we'll eat them and oh, Vera, it's so exciting. Are you all right, my dear? Vera, you all right?
Can't wait, baby cake.
Wench! We're off to plunder the South Seas together. We'll live in Tahiti on coconuts and love.
Stanley. Stanley, Tahiti's nice. But let's be practical. You gotta get your medical degree. No, I don't care. I'll even go back to waiting tables. I always saw myself with a doctor.
Carmen.
Yeah.
I love you.
Look at this cake I got for you. You like it?
Too bad Bump and Boomer missed the birthday bash. They would have really enjoyed Vera's virtuoso performance.
Al, would you come below with me for a moment?
Cool it, will you, Vera? You just got married.
Oh, no, silly. Is that all you men ever think of? No, I want you to help me with Kate's birthday present.
Take off your pants.
How about a cold shower first?
Perhaps a cold grave.
What the heck? The skull and crossbones? And who invited Bongo? Whoa!
Max, and left me to die with the sharks, and now I shall return that thing.
Alec, no, please!
Alec, put down that sword!
Shut up, Max!
No!
This is a special underwater transmitter, Max. It sends one word over and over loud and clear. It can be heard for miles and understood only by sharks. And do you know what that word is, Max?
Supper?
Oh, I have waited for a long time for this, Max. Prepare to die.
Wait a minute, hold it, stop, hold everything. Stop everything, that jerk cannot be my brother. Now this jerk, him, he could be my brother.
What I want is for you to take your pants off.
This is very familiar. Are you friends with an old lady from New York?
You rhyme, dude? Ho! Drop it, lady.
I taught fencing at the Alhambra Institute in Granada, España. Well, I played Hamlet at the Civic Theater, Kokomo, Indiana. On guard!
What's happening? Alec! Katie!
All right, Smoothball. We're gonna do this one-on-one. Ha!
Me, Alec.
But I killed you. How?
Vera's gun had blanks, you dumb schmuck.
Oh, Johnny. Johnny, you were the only one I really loved. I would have killed them all just to be with you.
Well, that's too bad, Vera, because I was in it for the money. The money. And the spies.
Darling.
You bitch! Get off of me, money!
No.
You! Max told me about the shark incident. You were the perfect patsy.
Miss Van Rouge, come with me.
You saved my life. How'd you do it?
Easy, Alec. My real name is Rachel Kincaid, I'm master of disguise. Walk down an empty street, nobody's there, that's me.
I hired Rachel to follow Vera to New York. I was afraid that she might try to kill Max.
In my disguise as Gloria, I saw Vera contact you in the club. So I lifted your wallets to check you out. On the ship, I distracted Bongo. Nearly blew my cover. Here's your money back.
Now you can't afford to go to medical school.
No. Now we can afford to go to medical school together.
I'm sorry I had to remain hidden for so long, but my first duty was to protect Max.
Max!
Daddy!
Max! Max!
Daddy!
Alec, is it you?
Max, are you all right?
Yes, I am. Is it you? Oh, Alec. You saved my life. You deserve to know the truth. You desperately want to know if you can trust your old friend. Alec, I'm going to put your mind at rest because I'm going to tell you everything from the bottom of my heart. Yes, Alec, I did try to kill you because I wanted the emeralds and the treasure. I wanted everything.
Max, you saved my life.
Yeah.
You saved my life.
You would have done the same for me. Here it is. Vera, hold on to that. Try not to ever let it go. It means everything to us.
Oh, my God. It's the cross of the conquistador.
That's it.
Oh, it's more beautiful than I ever imagined.
I told you.
Oh, those emeralds look flawless. Four purple pearls.
See the cross?
Yeah, you all right?
Oh, fine.
What happened down there?
I don't know. Next thing I know, your father's pulling me up out of the water. I got it. So what about your dream, Max?
Oh, it's our dream, Alec. Max and I are just going to take the boat and we'll sail around the world. Live off the bounty of the sea. It'll be the perfect second honeymoon. And Alec, now we can finally finance your script. If you ever get around to finishing it.
You know, down there, there was a moment when I thought I was gonna die. And in that time, my life flashed in front of me, but it wasn't the life that I had led. It was a life that might have been. And I think that's my screenplay. I'm gonna write that.
Wait. Does it have a nice ending?
Yes, it has a nice ending. We fall madly in love. We sail out into the sunset. And we live happily ever after.
I like it.
Always cheer when the good guy won the girl.
It's the girl.
Those kind of movies.
So Alec's script got produced and became a smash success. A tall tale of true love, lost treasure, and lasting friendship. And yes, all of us did live happily ever after.
Just for fools.